सहायक शिक्षण प्रसारक मंडळ चापोली, संजीवनी महाविद्यालय चापोली, ॲफिलिएटेड बाय स्वामी रामानंद तीर्थ मराठवाडे, मराठवाडा युनिव्हर्सिटी, नांदेड. गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल द स्टुडंट ऑफ BSc SY, क्लास BSc SY, सब्जेक्ट झूलॉजी, सेमिस्टर थर्ड. नेम ऑफ द पेपर कंपॅरेटिव्ह ॲनॉटॉमी अँड फिजिओलॉजी. पेपर नंबर 7th, युनिट नंबर 1st, कंपॅरेटिव्ह ॲनॉटॉमी ऑफ व्हर्टिब्रेट इंड्यूमेंट. इन द लास्ट पिरियड, गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल द स्टुडंट, मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर थोरात मंदाकिनी मनोहर, असिस्टंट प्रोफेसर अँड HOD ऑफ झूलॉजी डिपार्टमेंट. इन द लास्ट पिरियड वी सी द स्टार्टिंग फॉर कंपॅरेटिव्ह ॲनॉटॉमी ऑफ इंट्युगमेंट. इंट्युगमेंट मीन्स ऑल्सो कॉल्ड स्किन. इन द लास्ट पिरियड वी सी द वॉट इज मीन बाय इंट्युगमेंट ऑर द स्किन स्ट्रक्चर अँड फंक्शन. टुडे वी लर्न अबाउट कंपॅरेटिव्ह ॲनॉटॉमी ऑफ व्हर्टिब्रेट इन द इंट्युगमेंट ऑर द स्किन ऑफ फिश. द फर्स्ट वी नो फिश इंट्युगमेंटरी. We know the fish is the aquatic animals. They are found in the freshwater form and also the marine water form. As their living condition, also their skin or the integument structure is also changes. The generally fish integumentary system, fish like other vertebrate have the 3 layers of skin. First is the outer epidermis, second inner dermis, and third is the hypodermis. Multicellular glands also occur in the some fishes. For example, electrics organ of eels and electrics rays, luminescent glands in the deep sea fishes. Thus, let us we see about skin of fishes. Skin means it is called integument. The integument or the skin is an outermost covering or wrapping of the body. Hence, it is the most exposed part of the body to the environment. For this reason, it play an important role of first line of defense in a number of ways. In fishes, the skin is well adapted for protection from injuries and disease. It also serves for the respiration, excretion and osmoregulation. Generally, in the fishes, they give the more important function like the protection, like the injury and prevention of the disease. They also serve as the respiration, they also serve the excretion and osmoregulation. It is also called water salt balance. In some fishes, special coloring devices and phosphorescent organs are present in the skin, which either conceal the organism or make it present or used for sexual recognition. In addition, some species have the special structure like electric organs, mucous gland and poisonous gland. In the aquarium fishes, we see the colored fishes we are see. Then generally, the special coloring devices and some fishes that is present by the phosphorescent organ, that is also called a light producing organ, which is present in the skin. In also the some fishes, they having the capacity for the coloration, that is the recognition of the sexual male gamete and female gamete. Also in some, they are used for electrics organs and mucous gland and poison gland. That is also they having the capacity for offense and defense mechanism. Then let us see the structure of fishes or structure of skin of fishes. The skin of fish is made up of two distinct layers. That is an outermost layer, the epidermis, and an inner layer, dermis or corium. The epidermis originates from ectoderm and the dermis derives from mesoderm layer. Also, in the screen we see the detail about the figure of the structure of skin or the integument of the fish. That is also see the detail epidermis part, dermis part. In the so the epidermis part, that is also the some mucous gland, scales, pigment cell, bony ridges. There are different forms they are present in the epidermis. Also the dermis, we see the scale, fibrous connective tissue, chromatophores, subcutis, muscles, mycoplasma, blood vessel. So generally we see that is fish, there are two layers. Outermost layer is called epidermis and innermost layer is called the dermis. The generally the epidermis layer of the skin in the fishes. The epidermis layer of skin in fishes, it is composed of many layers of flattened and moist epithelial cells. The innermost layer is called stratum germinatum. This layer is made up of active columnar cells that continuously divide by mitotic division. The newly formed cells occupy the lowermost stratum and the older cell move outside and are worn off time to time and maintain stratum germinatum. This layer is made up of active columnar cells that continuously divide by the mitotic division. The newly formed cells occupy the lowermost stratum and the older cells move outside and are worn off time to time and maintain the growth. These migrating epithelial cells fill the superficial wound. In also the epidermis part, we see the epidermal glands. The epidermal gland, the epithelium of epidermis is modified into a variety of glands, which are first is the mucous gland. The epidermis is provided with a number of mucous glands which open at the surface of the skin by minute pores. These glands are flask shape or tubular, extending to the dermis. The mucous gland secrete the slippery mucus which contain a lipoprotein known as mucin. The slimy mucus reduces drag on fish while swimming in the water. Continuous secretion and sloughing of mucus wash away microorganisms and irritants which may cause disease of accumulated. In some species, Protopterus, for example, Protopterus fish and Lepidosiren, the mucus forms a cocoon-like structure around the body to avoid the dry condition of weather, especially during the estivation period. The mucus give a characteristic fish odor. Among the some fishes, mucus is used for chemical communication. Many teleosts feed their young ones on the mucus secreted in the large quantity on the surface of the body. Some species like the Micropodus and Gasteroides use their sticky mucus for the preparation of nest for laying the eggs. The mucus also helps in regulating to some extent the osmotic exchange of water and ions between the body fluids and the environment. Second gland is the poison gland. Poison gland. In some fishes, poison glands are present. It is also called venom, or the poison glands have evolved in the different features families of the fishes. Glandular cells of the epidermis are modified into the poison glands. These glands secrete the poisonous substance to protect themselves from the enemy for the defense. They also used for offense as well. The poison glands are generally present at the base of the epithelium. In many marine species or of species, special multicellular glands are developed from the stratum germanatum of epidermis part. These glands are deeply sealed into dermis and produce the light. These light producing luminous organs are mostly found in the deep sea elasmobranches and in some teleosts, inhabiting total darkness in the sea. Each gland has an apex consisting of mucous cells that helps to magnify the light produced from the basal glandular part of the gland. These, the epidermis part. Second part is the dermis. The dermis, layer of skin in the fishes. The dermis lies beneath the epidermis part. This layer contains the blood vessel, nerves, connective tissue and the sense organ. The upper layer of dermis is made up of loose connective tissue and is known as stratum spongiceum, while the lower part is occurred by a thick and dense connective tissue called the stratum compactum. This layer is generally has proteinaceous collagen fibers and mesenchymal cells. The dermis is well supplied by the blood vessel. Hence, it is also called the provide the nourishment to the epidermis part. This also, when we see the ventral VS section or the vertical section of the fish of the skin, we see the detail about mucous cell, polygonal cell, cystic cell, columnar cell, different lymphocytes, they are formed. The generally in the scales in the fishes, scales are the derivatives of mesenchymal cells of the dermis. Some fishes are the naked devoid of the scale. For example, freshwater catfish, certain species exhibit and the scale. The generally scales are the derivatives of mesenchymal cells of the dermis part. Also in some fishes, some are naked, that is the absence of the scale. Some freshwater catfishes, some species, that is the presence of the scale. There are also the four types of the scales in the fishes, like the placoid scale, cosmoid scale, ganoid scale, actinoid scale. This is the different derivatives of the mesenchymal cells of the dermis part. Generally, today we learn about the integument or the skin of fishes, their structure. In the next period, we see the structure of amphibia. Yes, goodbye the student, and give these notes with the help of the video. Yes, goodbye the student.